To our administrators and teachers, good morning. Welcome to our in-service training 2021. At this point, I will introduce to you my co-facilitators in this seminar. We have Mr. Ruben D. Impang, Editor, Teacher 1 in Secondary. Mrs. Rhoda A. Dalugdog, Teacher in Senior High School and our demonstrator of the different physical fitness tests. And yours truly, Aileen M. Riancho, Teacher 3 of Napu Elementary School. Our topic this morning is about the revised physical fitness test. So we will start with questions about our expectations for this seminar. Question number one, what do you know about physical fitness? Number two, what will make this training successful? And number three, what do you expect to gain after this training? So you can share your expectations with your co-teachers and you will come up with one output per school. So after the leveling of expectation, we will proceed to the physical fitness test protocols. Number one, preparation of paraphernalia such as first aid kit, drinking water, scorecard, test equipment or materials. For the scorecard, you're going to fill it out on Friday for the actual or the conduct of physical fitness test. And for the test equipment or materials, as we go along in our discussion on the different physical fitness tests, I will also give you the different materials that we are going to use in the different test. Number two, during the testing day, we are going to observe the following. Letter A, testing station should be safe, meaning it should be safe from our students to perform the different test. Letter B, teacher must be present during the test. So do not leave your students during the conduct of the different physical fitness test to avoid any untoward incidents. Letter C,
test requiring cardiovascular endurance and those other tests which involve the same muscle groups should not be taken in succession. So it could be possible that for day 1, day 2, and day 3, you can do or conduct the physical fitness test by 2 or by 3 tests to avoid muscle cramps.
Letter D, let the tester record the scores while the student keeps the result of his own performance in the scorecard. Letter E, the student shall be grouped together and in pairs, meaning they are going to do the buddy-buddy system. They will work in pairs. Letter F, the student should wear appropriate clothing. So you are going to wear sportswear or sports attire at this time. Next, the student should take no food or drinks 3 hours before taking the BMI test, meaning the body mass index test. Then lastly, administer the test in a challenging, encouraging, and fun-filled environment. Number three, students who are 15 years of age and above should answer the PARQ and U questionnaire before taking the test. So this form, PARQ questionnaire, is already given also together with your scorecard. So you have to fill this out before you are going to perform the definite test, the physical fitness test. Today, we're going to start our discussion on the different physical fitness test, recording, interpretation of result, and action plan making. So the whole duration this morning, we are going to have the discussion. And on Friday, you will have the conduct of the different physical fitness test. What this physical fitness test. It is a set of measures designed to determine a student's level of physical fitness. It is intended to test two categories of physical fitness test, commonly health-related and skill-related. What is health-related components? Health-related components refer to those physical attributes which enable a person to cope with the requirements of daily living, such as cardiovascular endurance or our stamina, muscular strength and endurance, flexibility, and the appropriate body mass index, or what we call the BMI. For skill-related components, these are physical abilities that show potential for good performance in certain skills, usually in sports like running. So we are going to develop the speed in running, agility, reaction time, or the quickness, balance, and coordination. So let's try to proceed on part one. Health-related fitness. Number one, we are going to determine the body mass index or the BMI. We are going to determine the body composition of a student. So what is body composition? This is the body's relative amount of fat to fat-free mass. So for getting the body mass index, we are going to follow this formula. So we have weight in kilograms and height in meter squared. So for example, the weight of the student is 30 and the height is 1.20. You are going to square, so that is 1.44. So if you are going to divide the weight and the height, 30 divided by 1.44, that is 20.83. And we will try to go over the classification. For below 18.5, that is already underweight. For 18.5 to 24.9, that is normal. The 25 to 29.9, that is overweight. And 30 and above, that is already obese. So 20.83 belongs to normal. So that is how you are going to get the body mass index of your student. So remember, in getting the weight, we are going to use a weighing scale or a bathroom scale. If possible, if you have the detector, you can use the detector. Procedure. For the tester, you have to wear light clothing before weighing. On bare feet, you are going to stand erect and still with weight evenly distributed on the center of the scale. For the partner, this is what you are going to do. Before the start of weighing, you are going to adjust the scale to 0 point. And then, you record the score in kilograms. Remember, you are going to record it in kilograms. In getting the height, what is height? This is the distance between the feet on the floor to the top of the head in standing position. What are the equipment? You are going to use the tape measure laid flat to a concrete wall where 0 point starts on the floor. Another is L-square, or you can use a ruler. Next, an even and firm floor and flat wall. Procedure in getting the height. For the tester, you stand erect on bare feet with heels, buttocks, and shoulders pressed against the wall where the tape measure is attached. For the partner, what you're going to do, partner, you place the L-square or the ruler against the wall with the base at the top of the head of the person being tested. And make sure that the ruler, when placed on the head of the student, is straight and parallel to the floor. And after that, you record the score in meters. Next is a 3-minute step test. What we are going to develop here is your cardiovascular endurance. What is cardiovascular endurance? This is the ability of the heart, lungs, and blood vessels to deliver oxygen to working muscles and tissues, as well as the ability of those muscles and tissues to utilize the oxygen. Endurance may also refer to the ability of the muscles to do repeated work without fatigue. Before you execute or perform this activity, you are going to get your heart rate. So it could be in your carotid, here or here, or in your radial or at your wrist. So what's the purpose of this activity? To measure the cardiovascular endurance, as mentioned earlier. What are the equipments? We have the step, the height of the step. For elementary, 8 inches for elementary and 12 inches for secondary. We are going to use also a stopwatch. Another, drum, clapper, clicker, metronome with speaker, or any similar device. Now let's proceed to the procedure. For the tester, you're going to stand at least 1 foot away from the step or bench with trunk erect and eyes looking straight ahead. Next, the first step of the sequence should be alternate. At the signal of go, step up and down the step or bench for 3 minutes at a rate of 96 beats per minute. One step consists of 4 beats. So up with the left foot, then up with the right foot, down with the left foot, down with the right foot for the first sequence. Then up with the right foot, up with the left foot, down with the right foot, down with the left foot for the second sequence. So you are going to observe proper breathing. So you are going to inhale through your nose, exhale through your mouth. Next is, immediately after the exercise, you are going to stand and locate your pulse, and in 5 seconds, or at the signal, start. You are going to get now your heart rate. Then while taking the pulse beat, do not talk. Then you count the pulse beat for 10 seconds. Then after that, you multiply it by 6. Then record. So for the scoring, you record or you let your partner record your heart rate after the activity. So let's start the video of a 3-minute step test. To the next activity or the test, push-up. What is being developed in push-up is the strength. Strength is the ability of the muscle to generate force against physical objects. So let's try to observe how you are going to perform or execute push-up. But we must know the purpose. So the purpose is to measure the strength of upper extremities. The equipment, we are going to use any clean mat. Procedure, for the tester, you lie down on the mat, face down in standard push-up position, palms on the mat about shoulder width, fingers pointing forward, and legs straight, parallel, and slightly apart with the toes supporting the feet. For the boys, it is different for the girls, push-up. For the boys, you are going to strengthen the arms, keeping the back and knees straight. Then lower the arms until there is a 90-degree angle at the elbows. Upper arms are parallel to the floor. For the girls, with knees in contact with the floor, strengthen the arms, keeping the back straight, then lowers the arms until there is 90-degree angle at the elbows, meaning upper arms are parallel to the floor. Next procedure, perform as many repetitions as possible, maintaining a cadence of 20 push-ups per minute, 2 seconds going down, and 1 second going up. For the boys, you will have a maximum of 50 push-ups. For the girls, you will have a maximum of 25 push-ups. For the partner, what you are going to do, partner? As the tester assumes the position of push-up, you start counting as the tester lowers his or her body until he or she reaches 90-degree angle at the elbow. The partner should stand in front of the tester and his or her eyes should be close to the elbow level to accurately judge the 90-degree bend. Next procedure, you make sure that the performer executes the push-up in the correct form. And the test is terminated when the performer can no longer execute the push-ups in the correct form, is in pain, voluntary stops, or cadence is broken. So we can watch the video for the push-up. In scoring, you are going to record the number of push-ups. Remember, for the boys, you have a maximum of 50. And for the girls, you have a maximum of 25. Then after the recording, you try to interpret the number of push-ups. Now let's move on to the basic plank. What's the purpose of basic plank? We are going to measure the strength or the stability of the core muscles. What are the equipment? We are going to use mats or any clean mat, stopwatch, or the timepiece. Let's go to the procedure. For the tester, you're going to assume a push-up position. You rest body on forearms with palms and fingers flat on the floor. Elbows are aligned with the shoulders. Next, legs are straight with ankles, knees and thighs touching together. Next, support weight on forearms and toes. Make sure that your back is flat. Head, neck, and spine are in a straight line. Then lastly, keep abdominals engaged or contracted. Do not let stomach drop or allow hips to rise. For the partner, what you are going to do? Ensure the availability of mat or smooth flooring or anything that can protect the forearms. You give the signal, start or go. And start also pressing the timepiece. Next procedure, make sure that the back of the head, neck, spine and ankles are in a straight line. You give 2 warnings. And then, you stop the time when the performer can no longer hold the required position or when the performer has held the position for at least 90 seconds. So, holding the plank position beyond 90 seconds is considered unnecessary. So, for the scoring, record the time in the nearest seconds or minute. Maximum of 90 seconds for boys and girls. So We are going to watch the video for the basic lang. For the interpretation, 51 seconds and above, that is already excellent. 46 to 50 seconds, that is very good. 31 to 45 seconds, good. 16 to 30 seconds, fair. 1 to 15 seconds needs improvement. That is for the interpretation of their result in the basic lang. Next physical fitness test is the deeper test. We are going to develop flexibility. Flexibility is the ability of the joints and muscles to move through its full range of motion. What's the purpose? You are going to test the flexibility of the shoulder girdle. Equipment. We need ruler in procedure. For the tester, you're going to stand erect. Raise your right arm, bend your elbow, and reach down across your back as far as possible. To test the right shoulder, you extend also your left arm down and behind your back. Bend your elbow up across your back and try to reach or cross your fingers over those of your right hand as if to pull a zipper or scratch between the shoulder blades. Next procedure for the tester. To test your left shoulder, you repeat the procedures for A and B with the left hand over the left shoulder. For the partner, you're going to observe whether the fingers touch or overlap each other. If not, measure the gap between the middle fingers of both hands. Then, record the distance in centimeter. For the interpretation in zipper test, fingers overlap by 6 centimeter and above, that is already excellent. Fingers overlap by 4 to 5.9 centimeter, that is very good. Fingers overlap by 2 to 3.9 centimeter is good. Fingers overlap by 0.1 to 1.9 centimeter, that is fair. For just touch the fingers, that is already needs improvement. And a gap of 0.1 or wider, that is poor. So that is the zipper test. Next, for health-related fitness test, we have the sit and reach. What's the purpose, sit and reach? So, you are going to test the flexibility of the lower extremities, particularly the trunk. Equipment, tape measure or meter stick. Procedure for sit and reach. For the tester, you sit on the floor with back, head and shoulders flat on the wall. Feet are 12 inches apart. Next, you interlock thumbs and position the tip of the fingers on the floor without bending the elbows. Letter C, after the partner has positioned the zero point of the tape measure or the meter stick at the top of the middle fingers, the tester starts the test by sliding the hands slowly forward without jerking, trying to reach the farthest distance possible without bending the knees. And then, bouncing or jerking movement is not allowed in sit and reach. And you can do it twice. For the partner, as the tester assumes procedure B, position the zero point of the tape measure at the tip of the middle fingers of the tester. See to it that the knees are not bent as the performer slides the farthest distance that he could. Then, record the farthest distance reached in centimeters. Let's watch the video on sit and reach. Let's try to determine the interpretation of the different result for sit and reach. If you get 61 centimeter and above, you will have an excellent result. 46 to 60.9 centimeter, it's very good. 31 to 45.9 centimeter is good. 16 to 30.9 centimeter, it's fair. Then 0 to 15.9 centimeter needs improvement.
Thank you, teachers, for listening and watching the first part of our training, health-related fitness test. So let's have a break. You can sit back and relax, or you can take your snacks. And see you later!